Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I have a terrific video for you today. One of the most difficult things to do is to schedule meetings with people outside your organization or company. I'm going to show you how to do it today using an Outlook add-in from Microsoft called FindTime. Let's go ahead and just jump right in. So there's going to be chapters down below, so you can jump around if you want to. And really important, I'm going to have a link to Microsoft's FindTime website also down below in the description. So I'm going to show you one, how to schedule this, two, how it appears when someone receives a FindTime email to vote on it, and three, how you can actually schedule the meeting once you get a consensus or a time that you like. I'm going to answer some questions going through here. One question I'm going to knock out right now is, what does this work with? It works with, I'm running Outlook on the desktop with 365, but it also works with Outlook on the web. I've already tested that. And according to Microsoft, it works with Outlook 2016, 2013 desktop, and also Outlook 2019. So I'm going to use the desktop version, but I will pop over into the web version just to show you where it's at because it's somewhat hidden. Also, another cool feature about this is I can do FindTime by doing a new email, which I'm going to show you. But let's say that I'm in an email thread with 12 other people and most of them work at another company and it's just me and somebody else on the thread. And someone finally says, hey, we need to have a meeting. I could do a FindTime with a reply to an email. So it's not just for a new email message. Before I do this, I wanted to show you how this works on my calendar. This was intentional. I just made this up. Today is Sunday the 13th. Here's my work schedule, the 14th and the 15th. Notice I've got some time in the morning on the 14th, some time in the afternoon. My Tuesday is pretty booked, but on the morning of the 16th, I got some spots, and then the other days are free. So just remember that Tuesday is fairly booked, and Wednesday afternoon is booked. So here we go. New mail message. Again, I could be doing a reply. Here is new meeting poll. And before I do that, where did I get FindTime from? It is an Outlook add-in from Microsoft, so I went to get add-ins. No spaces. FindTime, there it is. And just to prove it, view details, it is from Microsoft. You can also get it from the link down below that I'm going to put. So now here we go, new message. This is really cool. When I go to new meeting poll, notice it says FindTime. The first thing is, hey, put somebody on the to line. To save time, I'm going to be doing some copying and pasting. Me, Carol. If you're having a meeting internally, then you do the scheduling assistant. If you're having a meeting with people outside your company, use FindTime. If it's a mixture, my suggestion is find out when the people internally you work with are free, get a few times using the scheduling assistant, and then incorporate them into FindTime. So as I pointed out, this was intentional. Carol and I work at the same company. So right now it's me and two people on the to line. That is why you see three people over here. So I'm the very first one and there is Carol next to me, just in case you're wondering. And one more just to add this, one more Gmail address. So now we're gonna have four people over here, cool? The first thing is, how long do you want your meeting to be? Well, right now this needs to be 45 minutes. I'm making this up. Do you only want to see work hours? It's basing it on my work hours. I'm Monday through Friday, 8 to 5. Watch this. Turn off work hours. You're going to see 12 a.m., 12:30, just to show you that. So here we go for the 14th. 9 o'clock, 9:30. I'm just picking times. We're free. Other times, look, Carol's busy, so I'm not going to pick that. I can go to another date, so I can pick times for one date, go to another date. Remember my Tuesday, I said I'm really booked. That's why I have very little availability. And I'm making this up, so maybe I jump to the 16th and pick five times are selected. That's enough. I could pick more if I wanted to. Hit next. I'm using Outlook. I use Microsoft Teams. So it's asking me, do I want to make this a Teams meeting? So obviously, if you're using Teams, that one's up to you. But if you're using Zoom or WebEx or something, for the location, you may want to put in WebEx or Zoom and then put in the link later when you actually schedule it. I'm going to go with a Teams meeting, and I'm actually going to put in here that it's a Teams meeting. There we go. All this is optional. If I click on Hide or Show, you can see what's here. I've been playing in here. Notify me about polls. Every time someone votes, I'm going to get an email. I'm going to leave that running for now. The second one is really important. Schedule when attendees reach consensus. It was turned on. I turned it off. If you leave that schedule for the consensus running, if enough people say this date and time works, Outlook will schedule it automatically. You don't even do it. So I'm turning that off for now. Hold selected times on my calendar. Absolutely, I recommend you leave that running. I don't want someone booking me when I'm trying to book one of these times. All these other ones are optional. Require attendees to verify their identity. If someone from Gmail gets this, they'll get a second email with a 5 or 6 digit number to verify that it's their email account. I'm turning that off for now. There are my times. Add to email. Notice it's I'm the organizer, 45 minutes, Teams meeting is the location. When they click on that five options, they're going to be able to vote. So now I'm going to send this and show you how it appears when people vote. I'm going to pick this Christopher Menard 9 Gmail. Do we want a subject? Yeah, we were doing a trade show for 2022. I am making this up. 2023. Let's make this YouTube video last a little while. All right. So it's sent. Gmail pop up. I intentionally cleaned out my inbox. There it is. So this is somebody voting now. They do not have to do this, but I'm going to open this in incognito mode. They will just be able to click it when they get it. This is me playing around here. Who are you? I am this person here. Click it one time. 45 minutes, show availability. Here we go. I'm going to say no, no, yes. And you can actually, just to be clear about this, you can have multiple prefers. So no, no, yes. Here you go. No, prefer. One yes, one prefer. Vote. If you recall back in those settings, that very first one says, hey, notify me. Well, I just got an email right here, trade show. The reading pane's turned on, so I don't even have to open it up. I can see that Carol has not voted and Chris A. Menard at Gmail has not voted. That's why they're in gray. This person just voted. Christopher Menard 9. No, no, yes, no, prefer. So that is how that works right there. Once a lot of people vote, you can either keep doing this, it'll keep adding to it as you get emails. You can also go and hit view poll now. I could also schedule this meeting right now. It says, hey, this June 16th, I could just schedule it right here. I'm going to just show you this though. Here is view poll, and then I'm going to answer some questions. And this is where I am signed in as me. That's why I had to do incognito mode just a second ago. I can also schedule it from here. And I told you I would show you this. Let me not forget. I am in Outlook on the web. I'm the meeting organizer again. I already clicked on new mail message and it popped up over here. This is in a really unusual place if you ask me. Send discard down here. Here's the three dots. Click it and look. There is your FindTime meeting poll. It does work on the web. I tested it. So anyway, I want to schedule this. When I schedule this new meeting, just to prove this, all these other dates are being held. Here's the 16th. Hold, 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 hold. So when I get this meeting scheduled, those will disappear. I do want to find no vote, no vote. There's a preferred. It's got the heart. Let's do it for the 16th at 9:30. Could have done this on the desktop too. Send. You have to decide how many votes you need, by the way, to schedule the meeting. So that one's up to you. You don't have to get everyone to vote because some people will never vote. I'll see if those other dates that were being held disappeared from my calendar. They did. How cool is that? There is our meeting on the 16th right there. That was done using the new meeting poll. There's my Microsoft Teams meetings. I said have a Teams meeting already in here. 9:30 to 10:15, and there are all the people I invited. Doesn't get any easier, at least to me it doesn't. So what a great feature. So only the people that are scheduling the meeting that have Outlook need to have FindTime. No one else has to have FindTime. Also made a note, make sure you test this before you do your first one. Just do exactly what I did. Send an email to yourself. I know you got a personal account somewhere. Do two accounts if you want to. Send it to a friend. Just make sure it works. Also, the link is below again. And make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I've got today. This could not have been any shorter. I don't believe. Anyway, thank you. Have a great day.